the Knox class frigate is it was an interesting one because we were in the Vietnam evacuation. We first landed a whole bunch of helicopters. We pushed at least 13 over the side, assimilating people. And after we had done that, we were assigned to go and escort the Vietnamese Navy from Khon San Island to the Philippines. And so we've gotten some notoriety for escorting 30,000 Vietnamese refugees on all of these ships to the Philippines, and many of them live right here now in Westminster and Garden Grove. We were off of Vung Tau, so we were part of what would, you might call a screen for all of the bigger ships, marine helicopter carriers, the carriers and everything else like that. And so we were sort of at the apex of the screen. We were saying our hull number was 1087. 1087, 1087, clear deck, you know, we were putting that out. One of our sailors knew a little Vietnamese, and so he was kicking that out. So that's where he came, and we were taking Hueys. We were landing Hueys. However, we could not take this 46. It was a big CH-46. And so he was waved off, and then we brought him back and let him hover over our fantail. And the crew story, of course, just gets right to the quick. Hey, I caught this bundle, and it was a baby. It was a baby. It was less than a year old kid. And the fellow who tells the story now, because the pilot just died, the pilot died of Alzheimer's just about a year ago. The guy who tells the story in the movie and everything is Mickey Nguyen. Mickey is now 46 years old. He was about a six-year-old at the time, 6 or 7 years old at the time. And basically, I mustered a bunch of volunteers to get under this helo and you know, accept people down. So after that, the pilot moved off to our starboard quarter and settled the ship. I don't know how he got his flight suit off, or he worked his flight suit off and everything, rolled the helo right, and he jumped out of the left window. And the enthusiasm of our crew, we had about 5 sailors jump in the water to go rescue him. I mean, we had a whaleboat ready to him and everything else, but the enthusiasm of the crew is the thing that, we had to pick them up too before all was said and done. And the kid who took the bundle was one of our engineers. And anyway, he, in telling the story, because we do have a film on it, he talks about the helicopter rolling over, and it looked like a dead armadillo. He was from Texas. It looked like a dead armadillo. Yeah, but
so the helo. That was your ship.
I was like, so
I remember that. Now he sat it in the water. He got his dumped his family off.
Yeah.
I didn't remember that detail that the kids were getting caught. And that was your
dad. Yeah. That's the one. I mean, I think that's. That's why there was a follow-up on it, because that he caught the, you know, this sailor caught the baby.
They probably did they know each other the rest of their lives?
Well, this all died until about 10 or 12 years ago, and we had a reunion down in San Diego, and at that juncture, it all came together. The first, there was a lady who now is, she's a TV personality on Vietnamese television. But anyway, at when we had our reunion, somebody said, "Hey, I wonder whatever happened to that lady that named the baby after the Kirk?" Because we followed up and went to Guam, or I didn't. My mother was passed away. I went home on emergency leave after this, but the ship ended up in Guam after, and all that was where the refugee camp was, and we found out that one of these ladies named her baby after the Kirk. What we were doing is we were assimilating near-term pregnant women onto our ship. We gave over our first class lounge and turned it into a kind of like a maternity ward. Didn't have any babies born, thank God, or anything else like that. But this lady named her baby after the Kirk. Anyway, so they put something in the paper, in the Vietnamese paper, about who's the lady, you know, anybody know about this and all that. Turned out she lived right here in Long Beach, and, you know, she came over and all that.
The one who was named the girl. The baby.
Yeah, the baby. The mom and the baby came over. Yeah, yeah. So, so anyway, what that did is that got the Vietnamese community back together, all the people that we were that we had saved and everything.
Oh, wow.
So, yeah.
What a great story. Wow.
Yeah.
Those people would have perished. You were just, you guys were literally, a Huey would show up with a load of people and you just shoved it in the water.
We'd take the people off, we'd strip it of all any radios or anything we could, that weapons or anything else that we could salvage, and then
away it went.
Yep.